Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Build a Force. Today's mission at hand is Operation Kodiak. And I think this might just be the final mission of the game. If not, it is definitely the penultimate mission, because we have been hearing about, you know, an elite core of enemy fighters over the past few missions now. And this is the first time around that we have actually encountered the term in any of the mission briefings right here. So yeah, supposedly these people are like a personal guard of a rebel leader. So while these enemies might be tough, and I'm expecting them to be tough, we should probably be finished with the Uzbekistan campaign with this mission. So yeah, without further ado, let's check this out. Okay, that is a very, very strange insertion pattern. Yeah, it looks so strange. I wonder why. I think I'll keep it like this. It looks a bit better this way. Yeah, it looks better this way, a bit more centered. Also, it'll also help me while making the thumbnail. Anyway, mission: attack and destroy the remaining elite core of enemy fighters, vowing to fight to the end. The enemy general and his personal corps of elite fighters have entrenched on a ridge designated Objective Skull near Jarkungan. I suppose that's how you say that. Black Widow will insert you approximately 300 meters east of their location. Proceed along your pre-programmed GPS coordinates. Locate the enemy, eliminate them, and recover the general's briefcase. The general's personal cadre of soldiers has vowed to not stop fighting as long as he is with them. The general must be eliminated and his briefcase recovered in order for this mission to be successful. This mission will be a failure if the briefcase is destroyed or if the general escapes. The general can escape. That is interesting to know. Does not seem to be a lot of enemies there, but I am assuming that they will probably take something like more bullets to be taken down or something. Anyhow, this is actually the final mission of the game, so I'm glad about that. Not the game, sorry, this campaign. Expected enemy forces. All source intelligence has revealed that the general's personal bodyguards are all highly trained and equipped ex-Pessas, police or special operations soldiers. Biographical intelligence on the general shows that he believes himself to be invulnerable. Expect to be met with swift, brutal, and intense opposition. Yeah, I do not like the sound of that. But let's see. Let's see how difficult this mission is. If it is too difficult, then I'll probably take the sniper and kill these bastards from miles away. Allied support. Alpha 1 and Charlie 1 will be inserted approximately 575 meters south of the general's suspected location. They will proceed northeast, eliminating any enemy units encountered. Situation: rebel resistance has crumbled and the general and his staff are running for cover. Human resource intelligence continues to be able to monitor the general's location. Currently, he is in the vicinity of Jarkungan, I think. The president of Uzbekistan is adamant in his demand that the general won't be allowed to escape. Bravo team is the closest to his last known position and has been tasked with running him to the ground. Making it great for him. Double load ammo, spec 45. That sounds all fine to me. Pity that we can't use the grenade launcher in this mission because we need the briefcase secured. Anyway, let us go ahead and begin this mission. I've been dying way too many times in this mission, and it is sort of beginning to piss me off now. And I have half a mind of just coming back with a far more powerful weapon and trying again another day. So, not another day, but rather just coming back with a far more powerful weapon. So yeah, this mission isn't that difficult, to be honest. I think even though I say that, I think I'm on attempt number 8 or 9, and here's the problem. Lately, as of late, these people have been getting pretty lucky. Luckier than they're supposed to. So, I mean, the first few times I cleared this mission like a breeze, almost. The first time around I was shot by somebody I didn't know, I didn't see. And that's pretty much what happens in this mission. You get shot by somebody you can't see. And the second time around, I pretty much blew myself up with a grenade. And guess what it said? Grimfangs got tired of life, is what it said. got tired of life. Bravo 1 got tired of life. Can you imagine that? A Delta Force operative getting tired of life. Anyway, I'm just rambling here. Where did this guy go? Did this guy? Yeah, there he is. Yeah, so ever since then, I think the next 5 times that I've been playing this game, somebody or the other has been essentially getting lucky. And when I say getting lucky, I mean they are managing to hit me and kill me, even though they're not supposed to be able to do that. Wait, there's somebody behind me? Over on this side? What? No, that can't be. But anyway, there are people down here as well that you need to be careful of. Be wary of. Like, for example, I'm getting shot by somebody from the grave right now. Excuse me. Yeah, there's an enemy right here. I saw him. I don't know what he was doing there because he was not supposed to be there at all. But there he was, that guy said, and I do not believe that is an enemy, because that does not seem to be one. There are more enemies down there, there are some more enemies over there. I will go deal with them first, because I do not want to walk inside a fairy. I don't want to walk in a position where I am flanked on both sides by an enemy. So I will take care of these people first, and then I will proceed. Not lag, not right now. Yeah, that's better. I still haven't figured out why this game just randomly starts lagging. No, I should have been able to see those enemies by now, but since I can't, that means that these guys have hidden themselves quite well. Stop moving! Let me shoot you. Let me kill you. Is there somebody over there? Nope, there's somebody behind me, isn't there? I think there's somebody behind me. I think there's an enemy element on top of that hole behind me. And that's the first time it has happened, actually. I've never encountered an enemy element on top of this hole before. First time that the enemy actually made it behind this hill, and first time that they have chased me up behind this hill. So yeah, it just goes to show how you never know where this game is gonna go. It's constantly changing. Shot in the neck. Should be some more enemies. There you are. Now, that's just one of the reasons why I like the Cheetah, because it shows me where the enemies are. There's also a way to activate a minimap, but it takes up a lot of space on the screen. I mean, compared to the full-blown large-scale map, it probably is the better option. But I prefer not to use it, because it can confuse, it can actually obscure a lot of the screen. And when I'm trying to look at things on screen, I sort of want to look at things on screen instead of having a quarter of the screen covered with a map that I cannot make use of while simultaneously shooting people. Plus the map also has like a pretty tiny display, so yeah, I don't really see much use in it, even if I do manage to activate it. There should be a person down there, I do believe. That is just a bell. I think there is a person down there. There usually is. So, what would be strange is a person not there down there. Those are all dead people. They're alive. And you need to be killed. Should be another person over here. Arroyo. Oh, come on. Stop lagging. I wonder what's causing all this lag. I mean, this is a game from 1998. It's not supposed to lag on modern hardware. Modern hardware should be capable enough to take care of it. have no idea who randomly started shooting, but somebody did. And it sort of scared me off. I was not expecting him to shoot when they started.
This is Alpha! Charlie is down! Charlie is down!
Oh no.
This is Alpha 1.
I don't understand why Alpha 1 and Charlie always go down together, because first Charlie goes down and then Alpha 1 goes like, this is Alpha 1, I can no longer continue. I don't know. But yeah, they say something along those lines. That guy's over there, I will let him stay there, I will not disturb him, because my objective is over there, and that is where I'll go. Hopefully this, I will not be shot through the back doing this. No, I wonder where the enemies are. There should be some enemies right here. There they are. One of them at least. And that was the other one. And now that that guy has been killed. Yeah. Enjoy the barbecue, gentlemen. I will go ahead and scale this mountain. Or at least attempt to. Because successfully scaling it requires a level of skill that I do not possess. I cannot see
any. Bravo, you're closing the objective. Stay alert.
Roger, K6. Now, it is a tradition for me to, once I get up to this point, sing Staying Alive. But I will not do that because, well, I do believe somebody is shooting at me. One ghetto. Like, one gift. In French. Can you... Yes, thank you. Why do these guys sound like ghosts, though? Is what I wanna know. I believe that is a dead man. Ah, there you are. My friend who was shooting at me from behind. Not really a friend, are you? If you're gonna shoot at me from behind. Alpha 1 is down over there. I cannot see where Alpha 2 is. I cannot see where the enemies are. From this angle at least. I see another enemy. Another one bites the dust. It's sort of strange that with this game, all the enemy kill sounds sound so similar. But I suppose one can always say it as what it is and leave it at that. Dun, another one bites the dust.
Dun,
another one bites the dust. And another one does, and another one does. Another one bites the dust. Yeah, I would really dislike you to lag right now, which is exactly what you're doing. And I have no idea why. Like, why would you choose now of all times to lag? Like, is this like a strategic attack against me or something? I do not see anybody down there. That does not mean there is nobody down there. They could probably well be quite... Why is it lagging so much? Stop lagging. Come on, you can do it. Yes. Thank you. I swear, if I die this time, it'll probably be because of the lag. I think that is the briefcase that we are supposed to carry. I completely did not see that guy at all. Oh my god, yeah. Let me just toss a grenade over there. Did that explode? I have no idea. Now, it does say that I have some enemies over there. I do suppose that is enough blind fire for now. I see another head. Let me go ahead and reload while I can. That I suppose was another enemy. And how did these people not die? I mean, these people should have been dead by now. I see two more people running over somewhere over there. trying to get into position to take me out. And not the friendly kind of, the friendly version of that phrase. No, I shall just play it a little passively, play it a little safe, wait for these people to surface before I take them out first. It's more of a game of who takes who out first, isn't it? These two people have been eliminated. I see the briefcase, eyes on the briefcase, King Six. I repeat, eyes on the briefcase. There is at least one more person over there. One person inside the tent at least, and at least one more person at the objective, attempting to move with caution. No person down here. This area is clear. Proceeding further. Taking a cautious approach. Hoping not to die. I'm just wondering how much easier it would have been if I had friends at this point in the mission. But yeah. I wonder, is that... No, that's a dead enemy. I thought that was an alive enemy, but it's a dead enemy. So I'll just leave that enemy at that. So yeah, I don't know if I've told you guys this yet or not, but the second time around that I was playing this mission, I made it to this point, and I decided to check a grenade down there to take out whoever is supposed to be right in front of me here. Right. And yeah, in doing so, I exploded the grenade in front of me. And while at other times I have survived a blast like that, this time around I died, and it said... Grimfangs got tired of life is what it said. I see you. And there should be one more enemy right here. This guy should be out in the open, I do believe. And I see the enemy, general. However, I will... approach the situation with caution, because I do not want to make things worse for myself. I hope there is a way to tackle this guy from the... Actually, you know what? Let's try it from this angle instead. Let's try it from this angle. Because we do not wish to expose ourselves. We can probably try it from this angle. Hopefully it is low enough that the general will not be able to target us with his weapon while we are busy killing him, because I do not want to risk the safety of
this is King Six. Target has escaped. Bravo. Cut off any means of escape.
What do you mean target has escaped? Excuse me? What do you mean target has escaped? Oh, there you are. Boy, you sure took a lot of rounds to go down, didn't you? King Six, target has been killed.
Good job, Bravo. Move to the extraction point.
Roger, King Six. Move into the extraction point now. We'll see you back at base. Oh, that was a difficult mission, my god. 39 kills. And it's sort of difficult to believe that, but yeah, the general actually did have more hit points. I shot him once while he was running away, and then I had to shoot him twice for him to die. So yeah, I mean, weird, but okay. 39 kills. Congratulations, Bravo team, on a job well done. Your efforts have been indispensable in putting an end to the civil war. The President of Uzbekistan extends his heartfelt thanks to you. Thanks for your help in restoring control of the country to its democratically elected leaders, who weren't really doing a good job in the first place, but being the entire reason behind the whole civil war. You won't be out of work for long. Other troubled spots around the world continue to be monitored by the Joint Chiefs of Staff. Ensure your well-earned downtime. It may not last long. I mean, that's not exactly the way you'd say thanks for a job well done. But yeah, with that, we have officially reached the end of the Uzbekistan campaign. This was also a long one, but how many missions were that? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 missions long, my god. And then there is Novaya Zemlya, which is, I think, I researched it beforehand, and apparently it's a section in, you know, just above Russia, and I think it's like a group of islands, like right above Russia, and these islands, like one of these islands also near the Arctic Circle, and one of these islands also has Svalbard as a part of it, which is like, I think, the capital of Norway or something, but then again, I could be wrong, who knows. So, at any rate, this is like literally North Pole at this point. I don't think even the Delta Force is equipped enough to handle this. I think this needs to go to something like an Arctic commander or something. But anyway, the next time we come over, since Bird of Prey is selected by default when we click on the Run of Wales and their campaign, we will begin with Birds of Prey. And as far as... what was the name of this mission again? Yeah, Operation Kodiak. I don't know what that means. I think that's a game, isn't it? So as far as Operation Kodiak is concerned, it was a simple mission. It was just taxing on the focus. I mean, you had to stay focused for a long amount of time to be able to do this mission well. And I think that's all there was to it. It was pretty much a straightforward mission. Not too difficult, not too easy either. A little challenging. And yeah, surprising to say the least. Is what I would say, like it was a surprising mission. But apart from that, that pretty much closes the Uzbekistan chapter, crosses it off our books. And thank you for staying on the journey thus far. Thank you for watching it with us. So, yeah, the next time we come over, we'll be starting off Novaya Zemlya. Thank you for tuning in today once again. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.